this is a matrix of the stresses in the atmosphere. So the Reynolds stress. Stress is similar to shear. So the Reynolds stress is essentially the momentum flux due to turbulence. Since it causes deformation of a fluid body, it is equivalently a stress that we refer to as Reynolds stress. So Reynolds stress is a property of the flow. It is called stress because it results in deformation of a fluid parcel. So you have a fluid parcel and then you have force, then the fluid parcel would change, right? That's Reynolds stress. Not because of the existence of a real tangential force, as in the case of the viscous stress. So, to describe Reynolds stress, let's just look at this. So these are all the momentum transfers and so on, right? So these are the things that affects the flow. So you have the U prime times U prime, one, V prime U prime, W prime U prime, U prime V prime, and so on. So this is the combination. So it's actually you have three U, V, and W, right? So the three combinations give you 9 combinations of stress. But not all of them is important. Only some of them are important. But to be complete, you need to consider all. For Reynolds stress, even though we have all of this, we don't have to consider all of it. We can just take one that is the most important. So one that you saw before is this. Remember? U prime, W prime. The momentum transfer. But just you need to know that instead of this, there's also all these other stresses. So we look at this going back to the Reynolds stress. But then the most important is this U prime W prime. When I say important, it's the largest value, and the V prime W prime. This is the one that transport momentum or transport friction. So if you already introduced the U prime W prime, and you know that that's a component to transport momentum into the ground or above the ground, the U prime W prime. And then now you see that there's actually a lot of other stresses onto the air that occurs on the parcel of air. But the most highest in magnitude will be this U prime W prime. And in comparison, there's also the V prime W prime. And we see that the values here is an order of magnitude larger than the values here. So the complete equation for this friction is actually this one plus this one plus many other things. You saw the stresses now. But when we actually calculate it, we notice that we can cancel because those are very small, like 0.0001, 0.0001, 0.001. So, but here is like 0.10. So this is a lot larger than the rest. So we approximate that all this can be cut. So the most important component of that Reynolds stress just now, we have all this 9 that acts on the parcel of air. The most important, the largest, not most important, the largest would be that one. So going back on top, frictional velocity scale, or U star, which is this one, is the magnitude of the Reynolds stress in the atmospheric surface layer. So we can calculate U star from this equation. And I told you just now that we can actually remove this one and just approximate friction velocity as this. And but then what we want to actually quantify is the friction, the total friction. So this and this is the same. This component is the same as this component, and this is the same component. So you want to get this one. You can calculate this from sensors, from the anemometer. This one is air density. I think it's 1.02 kilograms per meter cube. So this is a constant. So this one, multiply this one, you can get from sensor, you can get the approximation of Reynolds stress. And this one can quantify the degree of friction of the surface. Large values of this means higher friction, low values, lower friction. And this relates to the Reynolds stress. Okay, aside from the friction scale, there's also the temperature and moisture scale. This and this. You can follow the same treatment as this Reynolds stress, but in the end, we see that this component is the largest. This component is the largest, so we can ignore all the other components. So the thing to introduce to you here right now is the scales. The friction scale, the temperature scale, and the moisture scale. Friction scale is for wind, temperature is for heat, temperature scale is for heat, and Q star is for humidity or moisture. Okay, why do we just focus on these three? How do we describe the atmosphere? Through these three parameters, right? Wind, temperature, and moisture. And pressure is related to wind. Now, the bulk aerodynamic formula for momentum. The bulk aerodynamic approach gives us a drag law, the drag in the air. It's very simple. Remember the U star just now? It's equals to a coefficient, constant, multiply the mean wind speed squared. So we can actually calculate the drag coefficient of air. Can we calculate this? Right? We can calculate this. Can we calculate this? This is the mean wind speed. So you bring this one down here, U square, divide U star square divided by V square, you get CD, a coefficient. And that's the drag in the atmosphere. Where CD is the dimensionless drag coefficient ranging in magnitude from, okay, over very smooth surfaces. Smooth is like ocean or maybe ice, snow, flat. It's about 0.001. Without a unit, it's just a coefficient. But over rough surfaces, it's about 0.02. So the higher this U star value means the higher the momentum loss into the ground, the dissipation into the ground.